Hey there. Hello. How are you? My name is Jettison. But as always, you can call me Jets. That's J-E-T-S, J-E-T-S. You're on my channel now, which means that you're in a quiet and a safe space. This video, as the title says, is going to be a what's in my bag. Now, typically, I really don't carry a bag. I just have my phone, wallet, keys, put those in my pockets, and go about my day. But if I were to carry a bag, this is typically what I put in it. So with that said, let's get to it. This is the bag in question. You can see a little keychain over there. Hopefully that's not too disruptive for you. Now, this bag is quite a bit larger than one I would carry, because as I mentioned, I really only have phone, wallet, keys. And if I don't feel like putting those in my pockets, I'll just wear like a crossbody bag. Now this one is not crossbody, it only goes on your shoulder, which is kind of a drawback to me, because I prefer crossbody bags. But this one has quite a bit of space in it, so I do like that. This is a bag that I would use if I'm going to be out for quite a long period of time. Which is not common, but it's a nice canvas, this leather tag. It's a nice green color. It was a gift from my partner's family. It took them a while, but they finally started to understand my aesthetics, so they give me pretty good gifts. This is my little keychain. It is a Siamese cat. Like my kitty cat. I'm gonna take it off so it's not so disruptive. Let me get a closer look at it. This is the keychain. Like I said, it's a Siamese cat. I have a Siamese cat. She's not full Siamese. She's a snowshoe Siamese. And this one has the little white paws, like she does. The only difference is that it has that. So it's obviously not a girl cat, but it's still really cute with its orange bow tie. And I don't always leave this on my bag because I don't want people to hear this all the time when I'm walking around or having to open my bag, but it's just a cute little reminder of my kitty. So I am going to take this off the bag for the duration of the video, just so that we don't hear the tinkling of the bell the entire time. So as you can see, it has a button here, which is how you close the bag, because it goes through the little loop. I usually just leave the bag open because I don't really have a reason to close it. It has a strap. Bobby pins right now because my hair is not at the length it was when I was using these, but I like to keep them on my bag just in case I need them, because right now I have bangs, and when I have a middle split, my bangs are long enough, I just kind of slick them back with a bobby pin to keep them out of my face. I don't know how long I'll have bangs for, because they've been getting on my nerves a lot. Usually a nice white cat hair stuck in here too because of my cat. But this is what it looks like when you lift that up. You have two pockets and then this area right here. So let's go ahead and open this pocket. So in that pocket, I generally keep three different things. The first one is sunscreen. Because I am very pale. I am like the color of a sheet of paper. So I have to make sure my skin doesn't burn. So anytime I go outside, I put sunscreen on my face and generally on my hands just to help my pale, pale skin. I've also heard that if you want to minimize aging on your face, it's good to wear sunscreen every day anyways. I don't really care about how old I look. I really have, but I don't want to cause unnecessary damage to my skin. So that's the sunscreen I usually keep in the bag. And then we have a hand cream because it's winter time, kind of still. I'm in the south, so winter's not really winter. Especially this year, it was oddly very warm. Shout out to global warming. But I usually keep some kind of hand cream in my bag just because my hands are so dry in the winter. They like crack. And it's not fun. It's not fun. So beside those two things, I also keep my chapstick in there because I also have dry lips and it's nice to have chapstick on. Because that it is winter-ish right now, so gotta have lotion and chapstick at all times. Now that we have seen that pocket, I'm going to open the other pocket. Okay, in this one, I keep this little leather case. And this leather case has nail clippers, tweezers, that kind of stuff in it. Because if I had to cut my nails recently, but if I, for some reason, one of my nails kind of like gets flimsy or breaks or I get a hangnail, I have to take care of it right then, or it drives me nuts and I can't stop thinking about it, and then I kind of start obsessing about it. It's part of the OCD thing. So I kind of have to keep this on me at all times, just to mitigate any OCD problems. When my hair was really long, I used to keep a pair of scissors to, when I was bored, I would cut split ends off. I would do that in class. Keep in that little pocket is this bottle opener because we went to the lake this summer and we needed one of these and I just never took it back out. So now it just kind of lives in this bag. But you never know when you're gonna need a bottle opener. This thing's pretty heavy, so it could also be a weapon if you needed it to be. That was these two little pockets right here, and now I'm going to show you what I keep in this zippered portion right here. Okay, the first thing is this, which I didn't know was in there. This has been there since me and my partner went to get sushi. As you can see, it's in, I assume that's Japanese, I don't know. But it says iced tea. I guess I just put it in my bag, and it's been living in there since. It sounds pretty good though. Okay, I also have, this is a coupon for cat litter, because I have a cat and it's good. When does this expire? Let's see. It expires 12/31/2024. So I can save $3 on some cat litter. Definitely keeping that. And then I have a menstruation pad, in case there are any people with uteruses nearby that were surprised by their menses. It's always a good idea to keep these or tampons on hand just to help out your fellow uterus having people. Because sometimes that stuff happens unexpectedly. Menstruation pad. And then I have these pencils. How do I? It's a push button. Okay. Yeah, I have these three pencils. Kind of hear the lead moving around in them. Oh man, that just kind of gave me a flashback. You remember when you would take like those end of year exams with the scantrons and stuff, and they're like, make sure it's a number 2 pencil because the scanner can only read a number 2, like, graphite, whatever. And they would get so mad if you used a mechanical pencil because they're like, are you sure it's number 2? Yes, I'm sure. It says number 2 on it. It's literally fine. And then I have a pen. I always have some kind of writing utensils on me. I think my sister need to write something down. You just gotta never know when you're gonna have to sign something. Alright, so that was these first sections. Now we're going to go into the heart of the bag. There's a zippered section up here too. I will go through that one last. I don't really think I keep too much in there. But let's see what's in the heart of the bag. Now, I film with my phone, so this isn't my phone that I use, but I would typically have my phone in there. So I thought I'd tap on this one a little bit. Because this is my phone, but I'm filming with it. So this is a little stand-in. And then, of course, I would have headphones with me, but I'm wearing those in the video. The only headphones I like are these, corded. I do not like Bluetooth headphones. Because I don't know why, but I can't get them to stick in my ears. And I generally can't have headphones in too long. Like, at the most I can have headphones in for an extended period of time is 2 hours. After that, they really start to hurt my ears. Even the ones that, you know, go over your head like that, the very soft ones, those hurt my ears too. So I typically just listen to things out loud if I'm at home. And then if I'm in public, I'm listening to the outside world anyways. So I don't typically have headphones in. Because it's good to be aware of your surroundings. Next, we have gum. This is gum that I just bought. I ran out of my other one. You see, it's unopened. So, like, there's only 15 pieces in here, but this will last me quite a while, because I really don't chew it that much. So we got gum in there, a comb, because my hair is quite fine, and it can rat up with a gust of wind. That irritates me about bangs is that they just kind of like blow in the wind and then you look crazy, and also they get greasy a lot faster because they're closer to your scalp, and dry shampoo can only do so much when you have fine hair. To keep a comb on you. I don't really use a brush for combs. It's green to match my bag. Kind of sounds like a cat purring. Cute. My sunglasses. I only wear aviators. I always get compliments on these. I typically wear gold aviators, but I get a lot of compliments on these, and I've had them for like probably 3 years now. They really need to be cleaned, but I wear sunglasses constantly when I'm outside. The sun is the worst overhead light. Anyway, yeah, those are my sunglasses that I wear constantly. They're pretty scratched up now, quite a bit dirty, but they still function how they're supposed to, so I don't care. What else do we have? Bottom of this bag is a bit gritty. Okay, we have my wallet. really a card holder, but it's got a little section here in the middle where if you wanted to, you could try and squeeze some bills in there, but I don't really see what the point of that would be. A little Cash App card. These are all my debit credit cards. I'm gonna back up like ID cards. Keep all my stuff right there. Usually I'll just take this if I'm just running to the store or something. Because I don't need an entire bag at the grocery store. We also have a granola bar, and I will usually bring a bottle of water with me as well. I do have a tumbler that I will bring sometimes. It's a really cute yellow color. But if I don't feel like washing something, I'll just bring a plastic water bottle. And I usually try to have some kind of snack with me in case my blood sugar drops. And this one's peanut butter, so it helps get me right up to shape. So, usually have water and a snack as well. And one of the last things that I usually bring with me is a book. Right now I'm rereading the first three books of the Halo series because I love the first three books. In my opinion, they're the only ones worth reading. Because I've read pretty much all of them. I read all the ones that were published by the time I was reading them in like 2014, 2015, and I read everything that was available up to that point because my partner at the time, who I was dating, really liked Halo, and then I got into it, and the first three are my favorite. And my partner now plays Halo every now and again, and they'll be like, oh yeah, Master Chief, and I'm like, you mean John? Because he's John to me. I know he's Master Chief, but he's John. He is the suit. But yeah, I usually try to have a book with me if I'm going to be going somewhere for quite a while. Like, everyone has phones now, but this is kind of a leftover habit from my childhood. Because if we were going somewhere that I was going to be really bored at, I would just bring a book with me. And I still do that now, just in case. Because after a while, staring at your phone gets really boring. Sometimes you just want to stare at a page. But yeah, if you like Halo, recommend the first three books, for sure. Okay, let's see what I keep in that zippered part. There's a lighter. And it works. I think it has a whole lot of oil in it, though. I don't really need a lighter ever, but just in case someone does, I have one. And then the only other thing in there is my house key. So I believe that is everything that is in my bag. Once again, this is the bag in question. Like I said, I usually don't even carry a bag, and if I do, it's typically like, you know, pocket size. Because I don't carry a whole lot of stuff, but if I'm gonna be out for an extended period of time, This is the bag I bring. Because it's got a bunch of space in it. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you tingled. I especially really like the noise of the strap. That sounds really good to me. But I wish you a good night. I'll see you guys in the next